We have two great elevator speeches coming up, one on mobile and the other one on social media. The one on mobile is called Xperia Studio, Bringing Marketing to the Next Level, a revolutionary always-on approach to mobile phone brand marketing. What a long title. The person who's going to come up on stage is from LBI. It's the Chief Creative Officer. Please welcome Mr. Chris Clark. Welcome, Chris. Good. How are you feeling?
Yeah?
Perfect. Don't worry. The second elevator speech that we have is on email social marketing and the art of storytelling. It's obviously about social media. And the two people who are coming on stage are Simon Putzer, he's the sales director Germany from Email Vision. And the second person is John Sadowski, author and leadership coach. Please welcome them on stage. Thanks. Come on. Hello. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Chris. Okay, Chris, you're first.
Okay.
You're allowed to start. Go ahead. Stage is yours.
Is that
Should be working.
No.
Great.
Yeah, something.
Have fun.
Okay, hello everyone. So I want to talk to you about something that we're doing for Sony Ericsson, the mobile phone mobile phone company. Sony approached us earlier this year with a challenge to try and change the paradigm for the way mobile phone marketing is done. They're getting a little bit tired of this idea of launching a campaign and then leaving the market and licking their wounds whilst other people start talking to their audience. So they wanted to do something that was always on, something that would engage consumers in the long term. And actually, if you think about it, mobile phone marketing is really, really dull. By and large, it's just a lot of people out there in the market talking about phones and features and everybody wanging on about who's got more megapixels on their camera. And nobody really doing anything meaningful, anything really engaging, which is a missed opportunity when you consider how much entertainment and opportunity there is in these devices. So it was a brief that we were delighted to pick up on. And look, I'm not going to go through all the planning stuff in any great depth, except to say that when we look at a challenge like this, we're always trying to find where culture, I'll put my walking stick down, sorry, where culture intersects with the brand opportunity and with the permission that a company has to really talk to people about things that they're interested in. And so what we said to the client is, be interesting in culture, not just in technology. And when you think about Sony Ericsson, with that Sony-ness embedded in the product, with the fact that they've got Bravia screen technology, they've got CyberShot cameras, they've got all sorts of great entertainment stuff in those devices, there's a great opportunity for them to engage with people in an interesting and meaningful way. So we felt that there was an opportunity for the Xperia brand itself to stand for something entertaining and for quality sort of branded content, if you like, in the digital space. And so what we've put forward to them is an idea that's now going to be a big part of Sony's brand marketing, and in fact, the sort of linchpin of their brand marketing going forward. So it's about giving people outstanding entertainment experiences, not just conversations about phones. And so the idea that I'm about to sort of talk you through starts really with creating stuff in culture, creating art, creating technology projects and apps and stuff that is interesting and engaging to influential people at the heart and if you like, at the target point of their audience. I'm going to flip through this stuff. So the idea is Xperia Studio, and Xperia Studio is a place where we get collaborators from around the world to come together and mess about with the phones, to try and break the phones, to hack into the software, to create films, to create content and applications that will be interesting and that will get people talking about Xperia in new ways. So it centers around a destination where all of the content is pulled together. That content also exists on the client's Facebook page and on YouTube, so it's nicely distributed out there in the digital space, but held together on Xperia.com. There's a Twitter feed, as you'd expect. There's all the stuff. And here's an example of one of the films that we've created.
Do
Illutron is collaborative interactive art studio. It's a mesh of people having different interests and different intentions and different explorations. We get inspired, take something that's coming into us. Maybe it's some scrap on the scrapyard, maybe it's something you read on a blog. And we use that and we modify it and we make something to put out in the world again. This weekend is a workshop where we got a lot of phones and we are playing with them, exploring them. We ended up with three good ideas. Motivation starts with playing with what you have around you, and because we are in the water, it's natural to try out and explore the water. It was actually 2 days to make a boat that sails on its own, is controlled remotely over the internet, and has GPS.
Like a driving game on the PlayStation with ordinary controls here and the back buttons here to rotate. It's like a racing game.
Somehow we started talking about scraper bikes. Basically what you do is that somebody rides the bike and it plots out these colors, and as the bike moves, it will draw those colors. I doubt that we'll be able to see with our eyes, but if you take a picture, you will get a hidden message.
The phone will be sitting here at the handlebar. Text messages received that changes the message that's being printed in the air.
Yeah, that's good.
What is the unique appeal to be a part of the Xperia Studio? It gives us a chance to play and experiment. Because now we have some phones and it's great processing power in your hands. So it's a new technology and it's exciting to play with it.
The basic idea of this is to use the gas flame as a flash. So it's just the standard camera app that Ben has put in the triggering mechanism for the fire cannon. So when you take a photo, it just shoots off the gas flame.
It's an interesting dynamic of something that has quite clear rules of what it is and how you're supposed to use it, and then put it into this chaotic, playful atmosphere and ask people to use it for something else. Everybody has made something really amazing.
How does it end up?
See, that's not too bad.
Do one more.
So all under the banner of Reality Remade, we're actually taking a handset and giving it to artists, to cultural thinkers, getting them to make something interesting that wouldn't exist before. So I think it's marketing as a powerful cultural force. And I never thought I'd get a client to create a flamethrower flash in my career before. So it's quite risk-taking stuff. But the great thing is that the phone is at the heart of it, and their permission to talk is at the heart of it. This stuff has literally just launched, so it's a brand new campaign, but already it's been featured in Wired and in Gadget and Gizmodo, and it's really taking off around the internet as a kind of cultural phenomenon. And I think what's interesting is that people are responding to the functionality of the phones, but in a way that comes to them through the medium of art and technology experimentation. So really, really interesting stuff. And I think it begs a question, actually, for all of us. This is a bit more of the coverage here. I mean, there's just been loads of it in the last few weeks. Is that there's an opportunity right now for marketing to do something a little bit more than it's traditionally done. Sometimes when I wake up in the middle of the night and think about what I do for a living, it frightens me that perhaps this is what I'm doing. It's making people buy things they don't need with money they haven't got to impress people they don't like. You know, I mean, it's quite a shallow profession in some ways. Especially if you're just talking about features and phones and not creating anything terribly exciting. But possibly there is an opportunity, actually, to see marketing as a way of building meaning into products, helping companies sell their goods and services by adding value, richness, and fun to people's lives, and maybe even revealing the poetry and the beauty in the universe. Now, that might sound like a really, really big aim, but when I show you the final part of this campaign, I think that might make sense. I'm going to show you now another collaborator that we're working with. Is a scientist, astrophysicist, who works for Columbia University in the US, guy called Dr. Josh Peak, and he's responsible for rendering images from deep space and bringing them back to Earth. There's no money in America at the moment, right? Apple's got more money than the American government and a bit less debt. So it's kind of down to companies, to corporations, to the marketing facility, really, in companies, to take things that probably wouldn't reach people, stuff that might be seen as art or entertainment, and to give it back to people. And that's what Josh is doing here, and this is what Sony Ericsson has done. And together with him, we've created an app that lets you see the depths of space.
Probably every 6 months or so, I get the sort of hair standing on end thrill of knowing something new about the universe that nobody else knows yet. I'm Josh Peak. I'm an astronomer here at Columbia University. You know, I pitched some ideas to NASA, and they've said, hey, that's cool research. So, you know, NASA pays me to hang out and think about cool stuff. I think it's really important to always come back to the layperson's point of view. We've built new eyes, eyes that can see so much more. And so I wanted to give people an opportunity to use those eyes. This is completely new territory to me, working with a mobile device. The idea of this application was to give a sense of what our galaxy and our universe looks like in wave bands you don't normally see. It's not trying to explain to you what stars you're seeing. It's trying to show you that which you can't see. It's trying to show you that which is invisible. The interstellar medium is full of filaments, clouds, shells. And I kind of wanted to give people the understanding that these beautiful, flowing structures are out there in space, that we've seen them, that we have maps of them. And all we need to know is what part of the data should we show on the screen, given the orientation of the phone. The trigonometry involved in putting this all together, I had to dig deep to come up with all of these matrices and so forth. And then the question was, how do we really make it show what we want it to show? Yeah, this is the one. It basically gives you your current latitude on Earth, so, and your current local sidereal time. You know, we're in this massive city here in New York, and of course you can barely see the stars. I sit in front of my computer all day, and that's how I look at the stars. So it's not at all weird to me to use a phone as a portal into the real universe, because to me those are my eyes. These screens end up being my eyes for seeing what's truly out there. The reality of our world, you learn as a physicist to discount to some extent. To realize that there's an underpinning reality, a reality that exists below the reality that we feel with our fingers and see with our eyes. What this app was originally designed to do was to open that reality up, was to punch a hole through all this junk in the way and let you see the vastness of the universe, totally present, at your fingertips.
So if you've got an Android phone, I recommend you download that app, but it was a fantastic opportunity to work with a client that wanted to do something meaningful, to put their products across in a way that actually adds value to people's lives, that gives them something that they wouldn't otherwise get, and that creates something of long-term importance. So the Xperia Studio is just starting. There's another five or six collaborators that are about to go live on xperiastudio.com. And over the next few years, we're going to build an increasing sort of set of relationships with people across music, fashion, art, science, and hopefully a lot more great stuff out there to sort of reimagine, if you like, the role of marketing in people's lives. Thank you.